Look, I've been having lots of fun over the last 6 months working with our colleagues at the University of Queensland, Professor Mike Bell, and also with Roger Armstrong from Victoria, trying to better understand how our soils nationally contribute nitrogen to our crops. And one of the interesting aspects of the study has been really to go and look at what's already been done rather than just go back out in the paddock and make more measurements. And the driver behind the research is really to help growers and agronomists to refine their nitrogen fertiliser decision making. We wanted to understand, you know, how much the soil supplies nitrogen through mineralisation of your organic matter, but also what are the risks of losing nitrogen from your cropping soil through, say, nitrogen leaching, volatilisation of ammonia, and also via other biological processes such as nitrification and denitrification, which are processes that can release nitrous oxide and also dinitrogen gas from the soil. And of course, once it's left the soil, it's technically no longer available for your crop. And I really want to just talk briefly about what we've found for Western Australia. We've actually found that whilst in some areas we have lots of information, we have a relatively good understanding of how much nitrous oxide has been lost, for example. In other cases, we've got very limited amount of data. For example, how much ammonium volatilisation occurs from our soils. In terms of soil mineralisation and its the extent to which it can supply nitrogen to our crops, we also have found that whilst there has been a few studies done here in WA, again, they're limited to a very few number of soil types. And given the extent to which our soils can provide nitrogen and possibly enable us to limit the amount of fertiliser we put on some years, we think that's really worthy of our further research. Similarly, ammonium volatilisation losses have the potential, depending on the fertiliser type and the conditions, to be quite high. And in a single study that's been done here in the West, we found that up to 30% of the nitrogen could be lost in the first 12 days after applying it to the soil. And that's not a small amount. So where are we heading to next? Well, basically, we're still collating all the information from across Australia, and we'll then be putting all our collective heads together to sort of work out where we need to go next.